What's up, everyone? I'm Justin Fraction with Technology Advice. Today, we'll be jumping into how to navigate the hiring tab in BambooHR. This is the third video in our how-to series for BambooHR. If you want to see the other videos we've done before this, you can check them out by clicking on the button in the top right corner of this video. Otherwise, let's bamboodily go. I don't know what that means either. It was just in the script. I don't blame me. Kyle does this. He does this to me, and I deal with it. So in our previous videos, you can see that there's a tab at the top that says hiring. If you click on it, you'll see a screen that looks like this. Oh, and as a reminder again, the info that you're seeing here is all sample data. No actual Technology Advice employee information is being shared right now. None, not at all. It's all fake. Okay, so there are three tabs within the hiring tab: job openings, candidates, and talent pools. Here under candidates, I can see the full list of employee candidates, which is filterable with a bunch of different criteria here on the left, such as job statuses, job openings, candidate statuses, and more. The talent pools tab is for storing the information of candidates that you'd like to access in the future. For instance, if someone interviewed for a role, they didn't get that specific role, but seemed like they might be a good candidate for a different role or the same role further down the line. But for now, let's pop back into job openings and let's add a new job. I'll start that process by clicking this button here on the left side of the screen. For this example, let's say we're looking for a marketing assistant. I can change the job status. Please note, if you set it to open, then that will publish it to the careers page and any other job board automation you have set up. So make sure you're ready for that before setting it as open. You can set the hiring lead and which department this job will fall under using these dropdowns here. Below that, we can set the employment type and the minimum experience level of this job, as well as the compensation and job location. This text box is where you can put in your job description. You'll see some pretty standard text formatting options that you can use, and you just type in whatever you'd like to appear. There's also a field for an internal job code if you have one. Once that's wrapped up, we'll click on the application details back towards the top, and you'll see a bunch of checkboxes where you can choose what information will appear on the application questionnaire. If you click on it, then that field will be required. So for example, right now with the settings we have selected, the questionnaire would ask for resume, address, LinkedIn URL, date available, desired salary, and website. But only the resume and address fields are required fields. Make sense? Perfect. Then below, you can also add an additional screening questions like short answers, yes, no questions, checkboxes, or request a file upload. So for instance, we can ask the candidates to attach examples of their work. Also, there's a checkbox here to note that your company is either a government contractor or you'd like to capture EEOC or Equal Employment Opportunity Commission information. And next, on job boards, you'll have access to Indeed, Glassdoor, and ZipRecruiter through BambooHR. Since this is just sample data, we don't have that direct connection set up, but if you were to use this with your active account, you could automatically have these set up to auto-post to these sites. Now, I can save this draft, or I can go ahead and post it if I go back and flip that status to open. And there we go. That covers the hiring tab for BambooHR. Hope that helped. Don't forget to check out our other videos in this series for more tutorials on BambooHR. If you're interested in other HR solutions, visit our website at technologyadvice.com for our top picks of HR software on the market today. If you like the video, like it, and subscribe so you can be notified of our latest and greatest. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.